Welcome to Resurrection College Prep High School's 95th commencement ceremony. I would like to take this time to welcome all those who continue to support our young women, especially the Sisters of the Resurrection, the board members, our faculty and staff, and of course, our parents and families. Graduation is always a bittersweet occasion for me. It has been a pleasure to serve the class of 2020 as their senior class moderator. But it's always sad to see them go. Although this year did not quite go according to plan, I couldn't be more proud of how gracefully these girls handled the challenges and changes they were faced with in the final months of their senior year. I truly wish you girls only the best life has to offer you as you leave us to pursue great things and make a difference in the world. Remember, you will always have a home on Talcott Avenue. I know you will make us proud.
Remember, we are in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Dear Heavenly Father, we gather here today to honor the class of 2020. Today, the day of their graduation. We thank you for giving each graduate the talents and the abilities required for this wonderful accomplishment. Today, as we look back on the previous 4 years and the experiences that have brought each of them to this point, let us first pause to give thanks to those who have helped along the way. For teachers, counselors, administrators, family and friends, those who have used their time and their resources to help guide and shape each graduate into who they are today. Graduation is a passage, a completion, and also a new beginning. Let us pray for your guidance in their lives tomorrow. May they have the courage to enter into their futures with determination, courage, and love. May each new lesson lead to understanding, each new challenge to new growth, and each new dream to a new accomplishment. Lord, we ask you to continue to walk with each graduate in whatever they do and wherever they go. In your name, we pray. Blessed Celine and Venerable Hedwig, pray for us. Risen Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life, guide us. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever.
St. John Paul II once said, "The beauty that you seek is Jesus. The love that you desire is that of Jesus. It is Jesus that you seek when you dream of happiness. He is waiting for you when nothing else satisfies you. He is the beauty to which you are so attracted. It is He who provoked you with the thirst for fullness that will not let you settle for compromise. It is He who urges you to shed the masks of a false life. It is He who reads in your heart your most genuine choices, the choices that others try to stifle. It is Jesus who stirs in you the desire to do something great with your lives, that will to follow an ideal, the refusal to allow yourselves to be ground down by mediocrity, the courage to commit yourselves humbly and patiently to improving yourselves and society, making the world more human, more fraternal. Today, virtually, we are here to celebrate, to honor you and your accomplishments. High school was a time that 118 of you experienced in 118 different ways. Some of you earned perfect or nearly perfect grades or test scores, took courses that did not exist when I was a freshman in high school 20 years ago, accomplished hundreds of service hours, and expanded your own understandings of the world, how it works, and your ever-evolving role within it. Some of you had incredible athletic careers, sectional and divisional titles, personal records, never settling for giving partial effort. Some of you expanded your own worldviews by taking classes outside of your comfort zones, going out for athletic teams that you didn't think you would make, starting clubs because of your interests, meeting people you normally would not. Some of you fought to simply make it to this moment, tackling incredible personal and family issues that would have made graduation less probable or almost impossible, but not for you. You see, graduation serves as an opportunity for all of us to honor you for your individual contributions to our larger community. It was Jesus that provoked within you the thirst that drove you to those successes, that did not let you settle for compromise. It was Him who urges you, and I mean this now more than ever before, to shed the masks of a false life. It is Jesus who knows your deepest desires, desires that others will criticize or say are wrong or impossible or beyond you or not for you. And it is Him that will give you the strength to push forward despite obstacles. For all of you, regardless of your accomplishments, it is Jesus who first instilled within you that desire to do more, to go bigger, to refuse to settle. Ultimately, it is Jesus who calls you to transform this world, making it more human, more communal, more reflective of charity and truth. The very last words Mary said in the Gospels were this: do whatever He tells you. For some of you, high school graduation is logical and makes complete sense. You and I journeyed together for 4 years, taking classes, field trips, going to dances, and so on. You conquered every obstacle in your way. You earned significant awards, advanced your own understandings of the world. For some of you, high school graduation seemed almost impossible. We journeyed together, you and I, more intensely, had many challenging and difficult conversations, going back and forth from one decision and one action to the next, one exam to the next, one life hurdle to the next. You all, however, made it together to this point, as a group, carrying different expectations, different challenges, and different experiences. You were never alone, and you will never be alone as you continue forth from here. What all of you have in common is hope. Hope is liberating. Hope is life-changing. Hope will ground you in your quest for future success and opportunity, for fulfillment, and for life-changing love. As a result of COVID-19, you all entered the post-high school world in a manner unlike before, leaving the security of home, of res, branching out into the world for the first time, mostly independent and fully prepared young woman in a world very different from one we would have imagined even a few months ago. Believe me, the unknown causes fear, causes anxieties. On a more profound level, you may be thinking, what am I going to do? Where am I going? What's next? What will I study? Where will I live? What impact, hopefully, am I going to make? What am I called to do, to become, to create? On a more practical level, what do I need to pack for college? How do I say goodbye to my friends? What am I going to do about this and about that? With fear and anxiety can also come joy and excitement. Branching out into the unknown will empower you more fully to embrace your identity as you and God define it. Branching out into the unknown will afford you profound opportunities of exploring the world around you from the perspective of a young woman called to make a difference. Joy will propel you on your journey as you take on life day after day, knowing that there is something out there, something profound, something creative, something meaningful for you to do. Branching out into the unknown will allow you to shed any previous fear and anxiety as you take on the role God is calling you to take. This only happens, however, in my experience, when you turn to Mary and do as she commanded, whatever he tells you. This will lead you to a life where you'll be able to live beyond fear, where you'll strive to do as God asks of you, and only you know what that is. You will find yourself in a state of total, profound, life-giving joy. There is complete liberation from societal expectations and trendy fads when your life choices are made from the vantage point of joy, because they come from a place of hope. In our world, we are bombarded by messages that more times than not offer conflicting directives. You will never find a shortage of people telling you what you should or should not do, believe, think, feel, and so on. You are accountable to God. Hope, when understood, will give you the courage to surrender your life, your will, to Him. This process can take a lifetime or happen in an instant. However, it starts and grows each day when you intentionally focus on living your life for others, for serving others. The work that you're called to do will be life-changing when others, family, friends, society, God, are the focus. We are meant to live in community. The very idea of being Catholic is one who lives in and for their community. The truth, my graduates, is simple. God loves you in such a profound and meaningful way that you can fully surrender your greatest, most precious gift, your life, to Him. And when you look back at the end, amen will be the only word you'll be able to say. Each of you arrived to this moment in your own way, and each of you will go forth on your own terms. Take the love that you feel today from all of us speaking to you, from all of us supporting you, your classmates, your families, your friends, and let that propel you into the unknown future. When you and I first met in this very room 4 years ago, I promised each of you at that point, in your own ways, you were called to do something great for this world. I have the privilege of supporting you as you explored and developed those skills and asked those hard questions. I am more confident than ever of those words that I shared with you. May God bless you always and in all ways. Now, let's get on to doing what you have been called to do. Amen.
Class of 2020, congratulations. You are fantastic young women, as a class and as individuals. We are all so very proud of you. You have set goals for yourselves, you have worked hard, and each of you have achieved very much. I am confident that you will continue to do great things. You have been challenged more than any other class with the pandemic and with all the restrictions that came along with that. But the way that you have dealt with all these challenges as individuals and as a class has been inspiring to all of us. You are truly strong young women. I hope you always remember how special you are to God. He has made each of you unique and unrepeatable. He loves each of you as a work of art. Always remember that the greatest truth is that God loves you deeply and unconditionally, and He will always be with you and never stop loving you. No matter what you choose to do, where you go, we are confident that you will make a difference in the lives that you touch and in the communities that you serve. We pray that all the years ahead of you will be blessed and filled with joy. Just a few words of advice. Listen to your heart. Be brave and bold. Be bold enough to pursue your dream. Your dream will lead you into a journey to discover who God means for you to be. When storms come up, don't give up, but watch for the magic and the bright new rainbow that will follow. Congratulations to each of you. Class of 2020, remember, we love you.
The Principal's Award honors a student who has demonstrated a commitment to excellence and growth in her spiritual, ethical, intellectual, physical, and social development. This year, nominations were accepted from faculty and administrators. After a committee reviewed the nominees and materials submitted with the nomination, I selected a student who I felt best exemplified an extraordinary commitment to learning, service, and to faith. At this time, I would like to acknowledge the young women who were nominated. Cheryl Cavins, Peyton O'Hara, Margaret Duda, Emily Riccio, Eleanor Baker, Nicole Bendig, Merle Kolbosch, and Regan McElhenney. When reflecting upon the young woman whom I felt should receive this award, all of the nominees readily exemplified what we hope to see in a woman of resurrection. However, I was inspired by our winner's dedication to her faith and her desire to use that faith as a service to God and to her community, as that was the foundation for her current and her future success. It is my distinct privilege to give the 2020 Principal's Award to Miss Emily Riccio.
Each year, we present the Sister Anne Medal of Distinction in Faith, Leadership, and Service to one of our graduates. This award is named after Sister Anne Strzelecka, who was one of the first Resurrection Sisters to come to the United States in 1900. She had a big dream and a deep dedication to the education of young women. Sister Anne started Resurrection High School 98 years ago. A woman of deep faith and staunch leadership, she was dedicated to serving others. This is therefore the highest award that Resurrection can present to graduates who display outstanding commitment to faith, service, and leadership. This year, we have four candidates nominated by the faculty and staff: Zuza Al-Harbi, Taylor Crawford, Abigail Kroll, and Rosemary Mulhey. Each candidate was interviewed by the selection committee, and I am pleased to announce that the committee selected two graduates this year to be honored with the Sister Anne Medal: Taylor Crawford and Abigail Kroll. Taylor Crawford is described by her teachers as a soft-spoken, highly respected leader who leads by example and commitment. Leadership is deeply rooted in her nature, as naturally as breathing. She knows what is right and knows what is needed and generously gives of herself. She demonstrates that in her prayer and in her faith life. Abigail Kroll. Abby is described by her teachers as someone who displays an outstanding commitment to her faith, engages in service generously, and is a stellar leader among her peers. She loves her work at Resurrection Retirement Center and helps third graders at Queen of All Saints with their gratitude journals. She volunteers with CCD classes at St. Francis Borgia Parish, and Abby is an Anastasia here at Resurrection and serves on four clubs and has been the president of the Scrubs Club. Abby is an exceptional young woman. Abby and Taylor, congratulations. I would like to give a special thank you to 12 seniors who served this past year on the President's Senior Advisory Board. These 12 seniors met with me for close to 10 hours over the past year, reviewing the school's strategic plan and giving their opinions and advice. I am grateful to them for sharing their insights and helping to build a stronger future for Resurrection College Prep High School. Special thank you to Abigail Kroll, Abby Kuzinski, Alyssa Esposito, Danielle Byrne, Megan Hurt, Margaret Lavelle, Nicolina Asinan, Olivia Whitmore, Rosemary Mulhey, Claire Ryan, Zuzu El-Harbi, Nayeli Soraria. Thank you, young ladies.
Inaugurated in 2018, the Resurrection Academic Medal of Excellence program honors graduating students for their achievement and hard work in the individual academic departments. This award recognizes individual students whose outstanding efforts have enabled them to meet challenging standards of excellence as manifested in coursework and academic achievement. Each department awards one medal per year to a recipient determined by department faculty and approved by the principal. This year's recipients are Religion, Alexis Suleiman. Science, Sheru Wang. English, Anna Battaglia. World Languages, Keeley Cunningham. Social Science, Emily Fagan. And Math, Claire Ryan. We would like to congratulate each of this year's recipients. Thank you.
Two Resurrection College Prep High School seniors have been awarded the Chick Evans Caddy Scholarship by the Western Golf Association. Those seniors are Emma Gillespie and Michelle Netzel. Emma will attend the University of Illinois, where she will study education, and she is looking forward to going into a field where she can work with teenagers or children. She has been a caddy at the Ridgemore Country Club for the past 4 years. Michelle will attend Purdue University, where she will study actuarial science. She has been a caddy at the Park Ridge Country Club since 2016. To qualify as an Evans Scholar, candidates must have completed at least 2 years of outstanding caddying service and have an excellent high school academic record, including high standardized test scores. Each scholarship covers full tuition and housing for 4 years. Michelle and Emma join approximately 250 other seniors nationwide as recipients of this award. Congratulations, Michelle and Emma, on your selection as Chick Evans Scholars. We are very proud of you.
The honor of class salutatorian is awarded to the graduating senior with the second highest grade point average. Sheru will be going to McGill University in Canada next year to study chemical engineering. She was awarded over $100,000 in scholarships and grants to that university for her academic excellence and her personal achievement. She is an active member of many organizations, including Esports Club, Girls Who Code, National Honor Society, Science National Honor Society, and Mu Alpha Theta. She challenged herself through high school courses like AP Chemistry, AP Calculus, AP US History, and AP English Language and Composition. Her most difficult courses, she says, are those that she enjoyed the most. Her service and her learning are a testament to her desire to effect real change. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to introduce our class of 2020 salutatorian, Ms. Sheru Wang. The honor of class valedictorian is awarded to the graduating senior with the highest grade point average. Rosemary has been awarded hundreds of thousands of dollars in scholarships and grants to multiple universities. She will be attending The Ohio State University, while she will be majoring in nursing. She has a true passion for planning, for service, and for leadership. Rosemary participated in numerous organizations while at Resurrection, including Student Council, Anastasia's, Science National Honor Society, Student Ambassadors, National Honor Society, Mother Selene Scholars, Spanish National Honor Society, President's Advisory Board, Scrubs Club, and English National Honor Society. Her academic profile is among the most challenging here at Resurrection, with multiple courses across every level. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great privilege to recognize our Class 2020 valedictorian, Ms. Rosemary Mulahey.
Hello to the fellow graduates, family, friends, Resurrection faculty, staff, Sisters of the Resurrection, and all other supporters of the Class 2020. My greetings come to you today from 7500 West Talcott, where though none of us expected to be witnessing our graduation from, seems only fitting to be the place to send us off after being our home for the last 4 years. We've spent the last 3 months of our senior year away from this place, and though there isn't anything I can say or do to make up for the time we've lost, I wanted to spend a few minutes reflecting on the time we did have here. Let me bring you back to 2016. 100-some bright-eyed girls walked into Resurrection College Prep. Our freshman year taught us that anything is possible. The Chicago Cubs went to the World Series after 109 years, and, more importantly, a small private all-girls school on the northwest side of Chicago won a nationwide contest to get one of the world's largest pop stars to come to our school. Did you know Shawn Mendes came to us? Personally, I remember that anything is possible on the day of the Shawn Mendes concert. I remember being in Miss Lenahan's seminar 104 when Becca came in right before Dr. P was about to start calling people down and said that she put a star by our seminar numbers in hopes that we'd be one of the first called. Because we were a seminar of all freshmen, no one really believed that we would be even close to one of the first called. But before we knew it, and to all of our surprises, we were the first seminar called down. We were front row, standing about 3 feet away from Shawn Mendes, and I can confirm he is just as good looking as in the photos. Our sophomore year was when we finally began to feel like actual high schoolers, instead of just eighth graders trying to fit in with cool kids. This was the year many of us began to learn who we are outside of what sport we played, what subject we're best at, or who we're friends with. This year will forever live in infamy in my mind, however, as the year they took away the morning cookies. May they rest in peace. I would categorize our junior year as the year of the three A's: APs, ACT, and accolades. This was the year we were told to build up our college apps as much as possible, which resulted in juggling either harder classes, more demands from taking on leadership roles, higher expectations in sports, and, worst of all, the dreaded ACT. Junior year was when we, as a class, were finally recognized as leaders of the school. No longer did we have to live in the shadow of the upperclassmen, because now we were the upperclassmen. However, with more power comes more responsibility, and though we had a lot more stress placed on us, we also had more opportunities to make it on the Res Instagram. Senior year was supposed to be the payoff from all of our hard work in junior year, and in many ways, it still was. We ran into the fall pep rally as fast as we could, took more than just a few pictures at the senior tailgate, and all pined for a DJ Slammin' shirt at homecoming. And I don't mean to flex or anything, but I did get one. However, I would be remiss if I did not give a special shout out to all the spring athletes, theater students, and all of my other classmates that missed out on spring events and a special celebration that was supposed to recognize them for all their hard work. Though I've spent some time reminiscing on our last years together, I wanted to share a piece of wisdom that was embarked on me in eighth grade. I was talking to my cousin, Kristen Even, who was the recruiter at Res at the time. What she said ultimately persuaded me into choosing Res and has stayed with me ever since. She said, "At Res, you won't just be a number." I can say with great pride that in my 4 years at Res, she was definitely right. I could hear her words as I saw Dr. P high-fiving people in the hallway, or Mr. Longo preaching at us to build bridges and not walls, or Doc going on one of her rants about how the ACT is a tool to keep the patriarchy alive. I could hear these words as I built a strong relationship with the attendance clerk, Mrs. McAndrew, who gave me so much support throughout my 4 years that I started referring to her as my school mom, much to the dismay of my actual mom. I could hear them in my senior year religion classes, where girls would begin every class by asking Sister Marian for a gumball question, or maybe even a squishy question if they were feeling up for it, and she'd always happily agree. I could hear them in my junior year Algebra 2 class, where my class would try to get Mr. Green off topic by asking about his love for robots and engineering, and he'd be almost as happy to oblige as we were to have some time off from math. I could hear them in the 3 years of English classes that I was so lucky to have with Ms. Justino, and the friendships I built with the girls in those classes. Above all, I could hear my cousin's words as I made my way down the hall in between classes, never failing to hear a laugh or at least catch a glimpse of a smile as we all went about our normal day. In all of these ways, Res has taught us that we are strong, independent women who have something valuable to share with society. And as we enter the world, especially the world as it is right now, this lesson cannot be lost on us. We must use the lessons we have learned in these past 4 years to make us more impassioned young women who are confident in their place in whatever room we may enter next year. I know that us, as women, constantly doubt ourselves and our abilities. We doubt whether we are pretty enough, smart enough, or athletic enough to be deserving of the good things that come our way. I know for myself, at least, I spent 4 years of high school doubting whether I was even smart. And look where I ended up. As Mindy Kaling once said, never let anyone tell you that you can't do something, but especially not yourself. Be confident that you have something to share with the world, even if you have to fake it. Our time at RES has encouraged our multifaceted nature, and though we cannot let this gift go to waste, never allow anyone to put you in a box or belittle your gifts and talents. Most of all, remember that you are more than just a number. Thank you.
With the authority delegated to me as principal by the Sisters of the Resurrection and the Board of Directors of Resurrection College Prep High School, I certify that the following young women have successfully completed the graduation requirements as established by the State of Illinois and as approved by the Resurrection College Prep Board of Directors. It is now my distinct honor to present these young women to our president, Sister Donna Marie Wolowicki, for the conferral of diplomas with all of the rights and responsibilities thereto pertaining. Congratulations. Malak Radi Abu Hashish, Zuzu Al Harabi, Mariela Alexandra Alvarado, Nicolina Asanin, Hannah Elizabeth Bassi, Eleanor Mary Baker, Lily Ann Barger, Jamie L. Barreras Coster, Anna Elizabeth Battaglia, Maria Nicole Belcastro, Sophia Belwar, Nicole Sophia Bender, Isabella Bialis, Isabella Rosalie Bongiorno, Lillian Marie Brugioni, Delaney Buckley, Margaret Victoria Buxton, Caroline Noelle Byrne, Danielle Ann Byrne, Sloane Margaret Caravette, Liliana Sophia Cardenas, Cheryl Susan Cavins, Caitlin Rose Schiavola, Elizabeth Grace Claybaker, Jessica Lynn Colucci, Caitlin Ann Coughlin, Taylor Marie Crawford, Keely Marie Cunningham, Claudia Magdalena Dabrowski, Giovanna Francesca Dante, Olivia Nora Delfos, Delilah Joseph Denka, Mia A. Diaz, Claire Sophie Dillon, Julianne Elizabeth Dobek, Margaret Duda, Nicole Delima El Bakai, Anais Esmeralda Escobillo, Alyssa Marie Esposito, Emily Elizabeth Fegan, Molly Delia Feller, Alexa Ferraris, Tara Alexandra Folino, JC Allison Gagnon, Rebecca Marjorie Golinski, Emma Evelyn Gillespie, Shannon Elizabeth Gillespie, Samantha Gomez, Megan Eileen Hurt, Grace A. Hennigan, Mary Catherine Hobson, Sarah Grace Holzman, Peyton Nicole Holney, Sierra Kaylee Highland, Caitlin Macy Jettner, Talia Kasabian, Brooke Celia Kadich, Meryl Carrie Kolbosch, Abigail Kroll, Abby Marie Kaczynski, Sarah Lynn Locke, Julia Lasorella, Tianyu Li, Jalix Lopez, Margaret Catherine Lovell, Mary Malaluski, Kathleen Ann Martinson,
Bridget
Ann Martinson, Ailish Rose McAleer, Megan Elizabeth McDonough, Reagan Rose McElhaney, Rachel Mary McNutt, Macy Alejandra Morales, Kelly Ann Moritz, Rosemary Ann Mulahy, Ellie Angeline Moniga, Amy Marie Nellen, Michelle Christina Netzel, Alyssa Nicole Normalini, Casey Marie O'Gara, Peyton Rain O'Hara, Jenna Amia Ortega Cazares, Leilani Marie O'Toole, Grace Ann Pavlik, Lindsay Louise Payton, Anne Elizabeth Quinn, Anna Rafik, Elena Francis Rafik, Shannon Ranali, Emily Mary Riccio, Colleen G. Richardson, Samantha Mary Rickert, Giselle Rosa, Claire Agnes Ryan, Samantha Marie Saldana, Olivia Joan Salinas, Cindy Santillano Sanaj, Liberty Angelina Sancione, Maria Alejandra Santa Maria, Emma Grace Salchuk, Natalie S. Shimon, Amanda Shero, Rebecca Rose Sluchuk, Caitlin Marie Snarich, Anna K. Snyder, Nayali Soria, Alexis Nicole Suleiman, Lauren Nicole Tebbins, Megan Bernadette Thornton, Alessandra C. Taliopoulos, Mia T. Vega, Kristen Villasenor, Sharu Wang, Maeve Elizabeth Ward, Olivia Elise Whitmore, Skylar Nicole Wilkie.
My name is Laura Tully Dennis, and in addition to being our alumni coordinator, I'm a proud graduate of the class of 1996. I'm honored to be here today to honor the class of 2020, who will soon be alumni of Resurrection College Prep High School. We are so proud of your accomplishments, and we know that you will go on to do great things. This class will go down in history. You have had an experience that no other class in the history of Resurrection College Prep High School has endured. You are strong. You are resilient. You are what Res Girls are made of. We know that you're excited to begin a new chapter in your life, but we'll miss the comfort and friendships at Res. We hope that you will continue to keep Res in your lives. We rely on the support and participation of our alums for various events, and we welcome you back to Res anytime. This was your home for 4 years. We want you to keep in touch with us. Res will always be a home for you. We hope that you can return to share your wisdom, guidance, and advice to our current students. At this time, I would like to continue one of our time-honored traditions and induct the new graduates into the Resurrection College Prep High School Alumni Association. We ask you, the members of the class of 2020, to pledge to be guided by the values of the Resurrection College Prep High School mission statement. We ask that you stay committed to your spiritual, ethical, intellectual, physical, and social growth. We ask that you accept the privilege and responsibility of alumni membership. We ask that you pledge to remain an active member of the Alumni Association and the Resurrection College Prep community, and help ensure the quality of education you received is available for future generations. We ask that you pledge to live under the banner of charity and truth, and to accept your new position of role models to the students of Resurrection College Prep, High School, and our community. Congratulations. It is now my honor to welcome the class of 2020 into the Resurrection College Prep High School Alumni Association. You will always have a special place in our heart. As an alumna, I am also honored to acknowledge the alumni heritage of the class of 2020. This year, we have 18 graduates with alumni heritage. I'm proud to announce the following students and their alumni family member. Lily Barger and her mother, Linda Strandberg Barger, class of 1990. Jamie Barreras Coster and her mother, Robin Barreras, class of 1986. Isabella Bongiorno and her mother, Nancy Bongiorno, class of 1988. Caroline Byrne and her mother, Kathleen McNaughton Byrne, class of 1982. Caitlin Shavola and her mother, Maureen O'Connor Shavola, class of 1995. Madison Dorband and her mother, Patricia Heavey Dorband, class of 1986. Tara Felino and her mother, Erin Boyle Felino, class of 1989. Rebecca Galinsky and her mother, Beth Stemper Galinsky, class of 1983. Sarah Locke and her mother, Erin Gleason Locke, class of 1988. Kelly Moritz and her stepmother, Patricia McGill, class of 1991. Anne Quinn and her mother, Michelle Canavy Quinn, class of 1987. Elena Rafik and Anna Rafik and their mother, Monica Sweeto Rafik, class of 1987. Colleen Richardson and her mother, Maureen Griffin Richardson, class of 1980. Samantha Rickert and her mother, Mary Ann Marbach Richardson, class of 1990. Liberty Sansoni and her grandmother, Susan Cipello, class of 1973. Rebecca Sluchuk and her mother, Susan Stapka Ringfeld Sluchuk, class of 1979. And Lauren Tebbins and her mother, Julie Brayback Tebbins, class of 1984. These graduates have continued the Resurrection College Prep High School tradition passed on to them from their mothers or grandmothers. For years, Resurrection has been continuing rich traditions and shaping futures. Alumni, thank you for passing on this beautiful tradition to your daughters.
Class of 2020, congratulations. We are very proud of you. We love you, and we will always hold you in our prayers and in our hearts.
Thank you.
Congratulations, class of 2020.